rising off the floor.
Jim and me.
Oh, my. We can fly.
You can fly.
We can fly.
Power. According to the Holy Scriptures, according to the Old and New Testament, the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahushai, promised us that we would receive power over the nations and we would receive power in general.
The sons of God, the Israelite, Yashar Allah, Yashar Allah, Yashar Allah, He is a prince of the power. He created us to be immortal, to be gods, to never die. To be forever young. To be forever young.
Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint.
Something out of you though, man. He gonna make you something terrible. See what he will do with you, Israel. Okay, he's gonna make you a damn machine, man. You gonna be the Most High's weapon, his secret weapon. A damn machine, man. Alright? Esau making fucking robots. We gonna be the Most High's robots, man. How about that? Watch. Watch it. You know? Wait till the Lord, wait, see what he gonna do with us. And he gonna change us, man. We gonna be something terrible. Something in your fucking worst nightmare, nigga.
Hey, Shalom, Akim, Shalom. First thing and foremost, I'm gonna give all praises and glory and honor is due to Yahweh Bashir, Yahweh Shai, Bashir Makakwadash, double honors to the apostles, the elders, the great millstone, blessings and salutations to the elect. Comment real quick, I had to do another video on the spiritual power, man. Alright, you can never do enough videos on these powers. You can do a video every day about this, man. The spirit hopped on me to do it. Because of it's been in my spirit heavily, because we're going to need this, especially with the fact that our bodies are breaking down due to the elements. Went into a video yesterday about how Esau is spraying chemicals in the air, and we have brick freezing temperatures, and you can feel it. You know, feel like you're being poisoned almost, you know. And you can feel it in your body. So we're going to have to be renewed, man. Because he's trying to literally kill off the elect. And if the Lord didn't stop him, he would very well do that. All right. But like he said, man, we're going to get those superhuman bodies, that superpower that you read about in the comics, that you see in the Avengers movies, man, that you watch in the Mortal Kombat movies and these other movies that allows these characters to have supernatural abilities, man. You know, as far as teleporting, dodging bullets, sifting in and out of the atmosphere, etc. Brightburn was a good example of that. The Matrix was another good example when Neo was able to fly by will. All right. So with that being said, through the spirit, hey man, the power is coming, brothers. Just gotta be patient, because honestly, shit, man, this is hell, and we have no power right now as far as being Israelite men in this society, because everybody has a foothold over us, from the women, the kids. It's Esau, Edom, animals, a fucking dog have more rights than us. The heathens have more rights than us, man. So on the bottom of the food chain, well, the black man is the top of the food chain, but he's the bottom when it comes to getting anything beneficial. You know, a dog have more rights than him. Momo has more rights than him. So when we get this power, it's going to put us back in our rightful place as gods on the earth, man. Because, hey, when we get that strength back, we're going to earn that respect back. Because right now, the Negro, Latino, and Native American men have no respect. Okay, like Yahweh Shai said, a prophet have honor everywhere but in his own home. All right, so your kinsmen, your family, they don't honor you the way that they supposed to, because in their mindset, you're nothing but a man. Okay, you're nothing but a man, a boy with no power, you know, under Esau's jurisdiction. You go to work every day, you pay bills, you pay taxes. You know, you have a woman that commits adultery, you have kids that's disrespectful. All right, you got brothers that's, you know, different, should I say, you know, gangbangers, criminals, murderers, Bati boys, you know, things like that. So when we get this power back, we're going to be magnified once again, man, okay? And I can't wait, because honestly, I'm tired of living like a freaking peasant, you know, tired of being disrespected by our people and heathens mainly, you know, tired of not having control. Alarm clock. I'm already at work. But anyway, you know, we're tired of being pissed on, man. And that's what peon means, to be pissed on. You know, your woman could commit adultery on you and you can't do anything about it. So we need that power, brothers. But anyway, this is the book of Isaiah 40. And I'm going to start at verses 29. It says, he giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth their strength. And we are the faint, okay? In these bodies, we feel faint, like, you know, in these bodies and the mind, all right, just period, you feel faint because, you know, it's a toll of hell that's building up on your person, from your mind to your body. You know, like right now, I feel like I'm fucking poisoned, man. You know, I'm tired as hell, and on top of that, I feel kind of lightheaded. I feel like I'm poisoned because in that air, you can feel it. It's kind of like last year when they did the polar vortex. I was in that air for 15 minutes and I felt like I had some type of radiation poisoning, man. You know, and the air is so cold and bitter to the point, you know, it's not natural. So the only thing I can do right now is pray, send up prayers and rest to get my strength back, because I ain't gonna lie, man, since the year began and since all this madness kicked off, I haven't been at 100% strength when it comes to, you know, feeling. Anyway, but, you know, it's all through the spirit. It's all a test, and hey, you know, it's up to the Lord what he wants to do with us. All right. But either way it go, I'm cool with the outcome. Isaiah 20, 40 and 29. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, because we're pretty young. You know, I came in this truth in my early 20s and I'm still young, you know. And it says, and young men shall utterly fall, but they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength. And they shall mount up with wings as eagles, and they shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Okay, literally, we're gonna fly, like they showed you in that video of Hancock, which is a good movie, by the way. Will Smith did a good job in that movie. As much of a Momo that he is, he played the hell out that role, and he's a good actor overall. You know, no cap. But nonetheless, we're gonna be able to fly like that. We're gonna be able to do things like Brightburn.
And I'm noticing lately they've been giving me copyright strikes. Every time I upload videos, they give me copyright strikes. But anyway, Brightburn. It's a good movie. I'm waiting on her to make a part two to it, but you know, Esau playing games, man. Make that part two to this movie. But this is one of my favorite renditions of Superman, because basically he was nothing but Superman. He was just as a boy, all right? Like, he got his powers at the age of 12 because it started speaking with him. And he had superhuman powers, man. He was able to shoot laser beams out of his eyes. He was able to fly. Hey, man, he was jacking people up in this movie. So this is the type of abilities we're going to get. And shoot, they based this off Yahweh Shai, because the scriptures say Yahweh Shai's eyes was red with wine, roughly paraphrasing it, man. He had bloodshot eyes because he drank a lot of wine. All right, and this is just none more but an embodiment of, but basically they tell you that this is Yahweh Shai and the elect, because we're going to receive power, man. All right, we're going to be able to fly, we're going to be able to teleport, we're going to be able to shoot rays of light out of our hands, etc. You know, if you have faith in doing that, because I'm noticing everything that I'm thinking is manifesting, whether it's today, tomorrow, next week, or next month. If I think about something overly, it will manifest, whether good or bad. So right now, I've just been focusing on positivity things because, hey, Yahweh Shai said it, man. He said, you speak life. He says, the power of life and death is in a tongue. You know, so if you say it or you think it, it can happen. So we have to use this brain power in order to manifest goodwill, because, I put prayers up against my supervisor, man, because, you know, they were just vexing my spirit. Now the nigga is back in the ICU, and in my spirit, he's going to die soon. You know, we're going to get that memo. Hey, old boy passed away, you know, and I can foresee that happening, you know, and I'm actually, I sent that up in prayer, all right, because these people, they are enemies to the Lord, therefore they're enemies to us, you know, and they have to be judged. But anyway, this is the book of Wisdom of Solomon 5, and let's start at 5, and matter of fact, let's start at 17. It says, he should take to him his jealousy for complete armor and make the creature his weapon for the revenge of his enemies. Who are the creature? The Israelites, us. Okay? And who's the enemies? The other nations, starting with Esau, Edom, and the 2/3 of our people. He should put on righteousness as a breastplate and true judgment instead of a helmet. And he should take the holiness for an invisible shield, and his severe wrath should be sharpened for the sword. And the world shall fight with him against the unwise. And that world is talking about Israelites, man. Then shall the right aiming thunderbolts go abroad, and from the clouds, as well as a well-drawn bow, they shall fly to the mark. And hailstones full of wrath should be cast as out of a stone bow. And the waters of the sea shall rage against them, and a flood shall cool them down. And yea, a mighty wind shall stand up against them, and like a storm shall blow them away. Thus iniquity shall lay waste the whole earth, and in dealing with overthrowing the thrones of the mighty, right? Okay, because this is going into the nuclear destruction, and this proves that we're going to get spiritual powers on this side. All right, because it says he should take to him his jealousy for complete armor and make the creature his weapon for the revenge of his enemy. So we're going to be battle waxes and weapons of war. Okay, and a lot of this is going to take place before the nuclear missiles hit. So, hey, brothers, it's coming. We just got to hold on, man. All right, one more precept. Yep, John 14:12. Matter of fact, and I'm going to start at verses 10. It says, believe it thou not that I am in the Father. It says, in the Father and in me. But the words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me. He doth the works, because the Most High is doing the works through us and through Yahweh Shai. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Because you're going to still have doubters out there. You're still going to have people that's going to come against us. You know, we're raising the dead and doing miracles. People are going to still find a way to discredit our works through the Lord. And it says here, but verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto the Father. So we're going to do greater works than the Lord. The Lord walked on water. So what make you think we're not going to be able to? We're going to be able to stand up in the midst of fire and not get burnt. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, remember. But anyway, I'm going to end it there. All praises and glory and honor that's due to Yahweh Shai. And with that, Shalom and above all.